Good morning, everyone, and welcome back to another vlog. Let's sing a song full of hope, full of pain. Why don't you sing along, my friend, for it's our last refrain. Forever young, ever strong, ever brave. Memories like this never end, no, they don't fade away. So when I'm gone, when I'm gone, I'll be right there, close to the sun. This is gonna be the first week of us living in the flat. I mean, I will be going back and forth, I think, between the two. Probably stay here most of the time, but going back to the other one to bring some bits over. We couldn't fit everything in the car yesterday, so they're gonna come over next weekend to help me sort out the rest of it, and they also need to take back bits like my TV that we don't need here and some other bags of stuff that I don't actually need. Yeah, they're gonna help me transport the rest of it, so I need to be going back this week to pack up the rest of my stuff and also to clean, and then I've got some bits that I'm doing with Carrie as well. So yeah, I'll let you guys know the plan and take you along with us. I'm currently in our lovely bedroom. We had our second night sleep last night. I had a way better night sleep. The first night, I don't know if it was like me just being excited, but I could barely sleep. I'm so happy with this place. It's the sunlight for me. Like, I'll show you in the kitchen. I'm currently in there. I'm just about to start doing some work. Aiden's working in the second room. My skin is not doing good. I'm gonna see if I can find any of my skincare stuff, but I don't think I brought, oh yeah, I did. I finally brought some of my skincare stuff here. Yeah, I'm gonna take you into the living room to show you the light, because just in the morning and through the day, it's just so nice in there. And it's also handy because we won't need to put the heating on as much, I don't think. Sorry if I'm being really annoyingly excited, but I just feel like this came at the perfect time in my life. And yeah, I'm just feeling really, really motivated and happy about it. I'm sure something awful will happen in the next couple of weeks to me, so I'm gonna just be excitable and happy for as long as I can. Let's go work in the lounge for a bit, and then I'm gonna start unpacking some more stuff. I really need to get on with emails. I need to change my addresses on a few things. I need to call up my council tax from my other flat and cancel it, and see if they can just stop that. And also sort out the Wi-Fi for the other place as well. This is gonna be annoying. Keep my hands on myself. Think I'll dust them off, put them back up on the shelf. Kiss my little baby girl. And just like that, it's dark again. The sun has set. It is 5:20. Still not fully dark yet. Look at it. I can't remember if I showed you. Did I show you yesterday? We brought my mirror in. It was a bit of an issue, but I've put it in here for now. I think it might stay here, you know. I envisioned it here. Aiden wasn't sure, but maybe he'll warm to it. By the way, we've got one of the sun lounges in. My dad brought it in yesterday so he could lie down whilst he was watching the TV whilst we were bringing the stuff from my other place. Which is not a bad idea, to be fair, because we obviously don't have our sofa yet and we still need to figure stuff out. Yeah, I don't know why I haven't turned the light on. I think I've just been engrossed in my laptop editing, but yeah, it's so pretty outside. I'm actually gonna go meet Ellie for a walk later on in a couple of hours when she finishes work. So that'll be nice, because I haven't seen her in a while. I think she's gonna come up and have a little look at the flat as well. My next mission, I've got a video edited and I've sorted all of my emails for today. I had to like message everyone about my change of address and everything, just so that there's not a lot of stuff going to the old flat. So fingers crossed everyone's got those messages. But I might message one of our neighbours in the other place, and if she sees anything come through for me, I'll just go and grab it off her or something, or get her to collect it for me. Next on my list is to tackle 3 or 4 more bags and boxes that I brought yesterday. I thought if I do it slowly, I mean, we did a lot of it last night, to be fair. I don't know how we've been running on like no sleep and just tidying and stuff. I think it's just the excitement. But yeah, I'm gonna bring some more bags into this room. I think I've got a lot of like beauty bits I need to sort out in the main bathroom. I think I'm gonna, that might take a while to organize, like a week or something, by the time I sort out like where I want everything to like actually go as a home.
Look who's joined us.
Vlogging.
Yeah,
I look like a rat.
No, you don't. Ellie came to join after work. We've just got a tie.
We do indeed.
Family tie.
I feel so adult right now.
She doesn't like it.
We've got the ick, the thought of the Uber Eats guy coming up the steps.
Right, so Miss Ellie Tyrrell has now gone. She's left us. And I've just been doing some more work. Aiden's doing some interview prep. So we've both been quite busy into this evening. I think it's almost 10 o'clock. But we've done a Gorillas order. There are like a variety of different like delivery apps in London, and yeah, they're pretty amazing. They make your like food come super quickly, so even if you're like staying in a hotel and you want some like snacks or drinks, or even they have like toiletries, homeware, some have fresh baked goods and stuff on there. So yeah, they're super useful if you're wanting something quick, efficient, you don't have time, or you just want stuff for like a little movie night or something. So yeah, I wish this section was sponsored. It sounds like it is, by one of the grocery apps, but we've actually just decided to get a Gorillas because they had some bits that we wanted on there. So I'm gonna give you a little haul, and I'm actually gonna pop a code on the screen and down below, because if you download the app and use the code, then you get £10 off your first order. It's worth it.
Haul time. So we've got some fairy liquid, and we just found out we already had fairy liquid, so that's great. I've got some crisps, some hippies, and some Eat Real hummus chips, the best. I've got some eggs. I like eggs now, even though I didn't think I did for 22 years of my life. Got some dishwasher tablets. We're gonna give the dishwasher a whirl for the first time. How exciting. Do you think when we first met that we'd be having a dishwasher together? Probably not. We've got some Minor Figures oat milk lattes, because this was a treat. I mean, we can make these ourselves, but they are just delicious. An avocado. We're gonna have avocado on toast tomorrow. Some of these we're gonna put in the freezer. We currently don't have a microwave, so we need to get on that tomorrow, don't we? We can boil them. Regardless though, we do need a microwave, so we're gonna have to buy that at some point soon. Another expense. Got some Pepsi Max. Right. Got loads of bananas, 6 to be exact.
Sorry. Made a fruit bowl.
Yeah, I really want to get like a cool painted fruit bowl. Is that too much to ask? Some green grapes. Got some chucky, of course. And then we've got some bread to make our toast tomorrow. A bit of a random haul. Good morning, everyone. It's Tuesday. I just got a text, our first text from like the concierge bit downstairs. They like text us when we've got post. So we've got our first post. Woo! So I'm gonna go see what that is because I have no idea. I don't think I've actually ordered anything here yet, or have I? I don't know. We'll see. But I'm just gonna go collect them. And then I've got a call with the doctor today, and then I'm going to see Carrie this evening.
So I went to collect the parcels. They didn't actually happen to be parcels. Two big like letters addressed to both me and Aiden, so I'm assuming it's a card of some description. I'm excited to open those and see who they're from. But I also opened, we've got like a little letterbox as well. Those were classed as parcels because they wouldn't fit in our letterbox, they were too big. And it has so much stuff in, so I thought I'd bring it out and sort it all out. I'm guessing when this flat wasn't occupied, they were still like sending promotional leaflets and stuff in there as well. There's some actual letters here that are like addressed to the landlord, so I think we're gonna have to maybe email him or something.
I've been drinking my iced coffee. I've got these reusable ice cubes that I got from Cherries. They're coming in an absolute treat. It doesn't water down my coffee. I'm doing a lot of like re-editing and things for some upcoming like smaller brand work, and then for the big project that's going live at the end of Feb, I'm just sending some stuff over for that. It's been a busy old morning, and yeah, I just need to finish editing stuff on my phone and my laptop. So if it looks like I'm on my phone, I'm actually editing stuff. Some leftover Thai, so I thought I would heat it up. We actually don't have a microwave yet, so we've just heated it up in some pans. Some rice and some Thai curry left. I've come outside with this lovely view. I'm just gonna sit here and carry on working. I'm editing photos at the moment for my campaign at the end of the month, so I'm gonna just do that whilst I have my lunch. Come back to my other flat to come and pick some other bits up. I needed to come back here anyway to do some Depop stuff because I've got to take it over with me. So yeah, I'm just about to go to the post office, then come back, fill up another load of my suitcase just to ease the stress for next weekend when my mum and dad come down again to help me, because they also need to take my TV, and obviously that's quite big there. Yeah, I've just been staring outside at the stunning sky that the camera is not picking up, which is annoying me. Is this Carrie?
No, I think it's the flat below. I had my doctor's call as well. I was super anxious all day because I was awaiting this doctor's call, even though there's nothing to really be worried about because it was a checkup appointment. And the gynecologist just hasn't replied about my gigantic ovaries. If you haven't watched my other vlogs where I mentioned it, basically the doctor told me last time that my ovaries are like 3 times the size they should be, which is literally terrifying. So I've got gigantic ovaries and they're not doing anything about it. But yeah, so she told me I had gigantic ovaries and basically hung up the phone and I just didn't hear back from them for 3 weeks. So I called the doctors again and the receptionist was like, yeah, we haven't heard anything back. So she made me get another appointment for this week. So it had been 4 weeks since my last one. And she was like, yep, still haven't heard back from the gynecologist. So we're going to call you back in 3 weeks. You have all the signs of PCOS. Have you ever been diagnosed? And I was like, no, this is what I've been telling you. I'm pretty sure there's something wrong with me. I've been asking you all for so many years. Please just diagnose me or tell me what to do to make this better. I need severe help. So she basically said I've got PCOS, but didn't diagnose me. And she said I could also potentially have endo because obviously you can't determine endometriosis without a laparoscopy, but I've got symptoms of both. So yeah, I could have both PCOS and endo, but probably I've 99% got PCOS. So whenever I can do, I'm going to try and do it. There are some quite like toxic things about it online in terms of like weight loss and stuff, but PCOS can actually make you gain weight as well. So a lot of it is to do with diet, which is annoying because I've been all sorts of healthy and not healthy and still had the exact same pain. So it really annoys me that they push so much on the diet front and everything. So I'm really scared that I'm going to go back into like a horrible slope with eating. Trigger warning, but I used to like starve myself and stuff when the doctors used to tell me like to lose weight or about BMI and stuff. Like I used to literally eat fuck all. There was times where I wasn't eating at all and trying to become really skinny to try and make myself feel better with this PCOS stuff, but it didn't do anything. It just made me harm my body even more. Didn't really get much further, so I guess we wait another 3 weeks for another call and hopefully they'll be able to put me on some sort of plan of action as to what's going on. I had to ask my mum about some blood clotting stuff from her history to see if it would affect whatever they decide to put me on. They're going to try and put me on the contraceptive pill, which I've been like, no, 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 for so many years, because when they did put me on them before, I went absolutely crazy. Like my hormones were all over the place. I was depressed. I was crazy for no reason. Like I literally was being psychotic over the smallest bit things. So I've tried to avoid them putting me back on that for so long, but at least it did make my periods a bit more regular, but it still didn't sort out the pain. So that's why I was like, oh, it's not really that deep. But that might be the only way to go at the moment. And I feel like I'm losing options. So I'm probably just going to have to go and try another pill and hope that it doesn't change my moods too much. To the post office.
Look who I've got with me.
Look how terrifying.
I'm going out like this if they make it on because we're super late.
You're not hurting any of them, are you?
No.
That might be kind of like a vibe. Like, she's in my makeup.
She's in a really weird outfit with no makeup on.
Yeah, that's cute. We've had a match.
I'm just going to put some oil on my face so it looks like on purpose. You're like glowy.
Like how she just had a facial.
Yeah.
Like a spa.
I don't know.
Not that kind of facial.
You naughty fuckers.
You dirty fucker.
Okay, we're going to go to Six Minico in Canary Wharf.
Excited.
So I'm an actual fool and forgot my vlogging camera. I also just had an allergic reaction on the tube, so I'll insert some photos of that. Oh wait, no, carry on show. Started having an allergic reaction, we think, to a lip product, but look. Wait. So yeah, that happened and we were super stressed. But it's alright. But yeah, they change their menu every 6 weeks, like a different theme. It's a really cool concept and there's one in Canary Wharf and one in Fitzroy. Yeah. And yeah, this is all like once upon a time, so fairy tale themed. So all of the drinks and food is relating to different like fairy tales and stories from our childhood, so it's pretty super cool.
So this is our first course. It's the Oliver Twist that I showed you a minute ago. Where is it? Potatoes, pickled onions, garlic. It's delicious.
Thank you.
Hello everyone. So this morning I've done a lovely yoga with Adrienne, full body flow. It was actually delightful, planning the rest of my week out. And now I'm just about to get ready because I need to film. I finally got my last few bits for the collection that's coming out at the end of Feb. So I need to film some try on vids for a YouTube video to show you guys what's in the collection and stuff. So I've just finished filming the video that I was talking about earlier. I filmed the try on clips. Me and Ada made some lunch earlier, which you'll have seen a little bit of. We just had we made a stir fry with onions and peppers. But look at the sun, you can already see on my face, like with the little grates from the heater. Just have to show you the sunset. I feel like my vlogs are literally just gonna be me showing you the sunset, so I hope that's okay. Wow. It's like reflecting on everything in here. So beautiful. I'm so happy I put the mirror here as well.
Bit of a random night. I didn't show my outfit, but I'm wearing like a red shirt and my knee-high boots that are killing because it's the first time I've worn them. We're in Leicester Square because we've been invited to the screening of Jackass Forever. We thought that'll be fun and random and spontaneous, so we jumped to the opportunity and it's at Cineworld in Leicester Square. It's like a private screening, I think. It premieres on the 4th, which is in a couple days' time. So we're gonna go see that. Hopefully it's fun. Really wanting some like cinema-y snacks and drinks.
With Amy, I didn't properly vlog, I just sort of filmed some snippets. We started the day having brunch at the Buttery in the Lime Tree Hotel in Victoria, or Belgravia area, and it was so beautiful. Like I had avocado on toast with poached eggs, so did Amy, and then we both shared a Nutella French toast because it was like their special. And then we took some pics. I had to shoot some stuff for the campaign at the end of Feb. I feel like I keep saying that in this vlog, I'm so sorry, but I've got a lot of stuff to do in preparation for that, so I've been shooting some stuff for that, and then some other bits that I wanted to do for my Instagram. And then we decided to take it upon ourselves to do some homeware shopping, which is kind of dangerous because I have been getting way too excited and invested. I will show you a sneak peek, some massive bargains, but you will see that in a homeware haul coming to you. It might actually be up before this, who knows. I need to sort out my YouTube schedule, so that's something I'm going to be doing tonight. But I thought I'd give you a bit of an update. I'm just doing some editing at the moment. Yeah, I need to show Aiden the stuff that I bought today because I don't know if he's going to be angry at me. Nah, he'll be fine. All of my purchases are pretty justified, to be honest. It feels weird that I've been out today and haven't really like seen him that much because I've been so used to like sitting in here editing or filming and like seeing each other on Aiden's breaks when he's been working from home. So yeah, it's very odd. Everything for the next few weeks is going to be so hectic. I'm actually really buzzing for it. I've got clothes everywhere at the moment. Clothes are the last thing that I need to unpack, and I'm just dreading it because I need coat hangers really bad. And I just hate sorting out clothes, like more than anything, like folding clothes, hang clothes up, putting them away in drawers. If I'm organising anything else, like the kitchen has my heart and soul at the minute. I'm fine with organising the kitchen, but the wardrobe.
Some products from Satisfyer. I've done some work with these before, but I honestly love them. They break down a lot of taboos surrounding sex, sexual pleasure, female pleasure, orgasms, all that good stuff. And they've sent me some of their new products. We've got the Hot Lover, which is a rabbit vibrator dildo. And then we've got a AirPulse stimulator, which is for clitoral stimulation. And then we've got a mini top secret one where you have like a little remote. You can take it out with your partner, basically use it for like fun, freaky stuff out in public, which I think is quite cool, not gonna lie. So thank you very much to the Satisfyer for sending me these bits and pieces. I definitely recommend checking them out. They are one of my favorite brands for sexual pleasure.
I'm about to head to bed and I will see you tomorrow for the last day of the weekly vlog. I'm gonna be weekly vlogging, I think, Mondays to Fridays, and then trying to have my weekends off or planning on doing other videos. So I think that is the
deal, and I'm gonna try and do weekly vlogs every week if that's something that you guys want to see. I feel like daily vlogs get a bit boring because I don't get up to much like every single day, but like a weekly, we'll have a bit of everything. We'll have some London recommendations for food or things to do, and then also some behind the scenes of like my life, my job. Please let me know what you want to see. I feel like social media is really playing me at the minute, and it's making me worry about my job, and I'm anxious quite a lot of the time because of it. So yeah, if any of you see any of my content and like it, I know a lot of like my friends and stuff are also really anxious and struggling at the minute too, in regards to like the algorithms on the different social media platforms. It's making us stress a lot about our jobs. Yeah, it's not a great pressure to have at the moment, especially with the new move. But any like, save, comment, share is just enough to support, honestly. Like, it means so much. Like, I really, really cannot stress that enough. So yeah, if you even like hit the like button, you're subscribed to this channel, I really do appreciate it. See you tomorrow.
So it's Friday and me and Aiden were like, oh, let's make a nice brunch together. It'll be so cute. And we don't have a toaster yet. We need to buy one.
Do you want to see the best bit?
What? Wait, what?
Which is one-sided, isn't it?
So Aiden forgot about the toast. We're making avocado and egg with poached eggs on toast. It's a nice little random Friday treat. Aiden was over here smashing the avocado up. I was about to poach the eggs, and then I smelled charcoal, and I was like, the toast. Aiden was like, fuck, so I've been using the grill, and clearly it's very intense. Grill works, yeah. So yeah, I'm super grateful. Thank you so much. I honestly wish you could have seen the panic on both of our faces. I was like running around the lounge, like, Aiden was going, quick, pushing something.
I think it like,
I'm pissing myself.
Imagine how someone reacted if there's a fire in their house.
Yeah.
I imagine it was likewise, if not worse.
Aiden was like, I'm going to set the alarm off for everyone in the building.
So me and Carrie are at Money Heist in South Kensington, and it's a new experience, so I'll let you know how it goes afterwards. Woohoo! Ooh,
so I'm sweating mess because we've just actually completed the Money Heist experience. Yeah, it's kind of like an interactive heist, and like we've run through like the buildings, we've like got gold and stuff. Yeah. We had like I don't want to spoil it.
Yeah,
I'm not gonna spoil it because I thought I was about to say.
Quickly speak about Money Heist. It was actually very interesting. It was like you were like in the middle of a performance for most of it, and you got to do a couple of like interactive bits, but it was mainly like performance based. You were sort of like trying to escape, and it was quite terrifying, like in a good like adrenaline way. I did enjoy it, but it was, I don't want anyone to think it's like an escape room style thing, because that's sort of the impression that I was under, even though it's not even advertised as that at all. I think it's just because I've done quite a lot of escape rooms, I sort of thought it was going to be like that, but it's definitely not. It's more live actors, you're like immersed in the experience. But yeah, if you're into that and you like Money Heist, I've never watched it before, so maybe I didn't get it as much, but I still found it really interesting and fun. You like start in this auction room and it sort of goes from there. I don't want to spoil it because otherwise I'll ruin the experience for you, but it's based in South Kensington, so it wasn't too far from mine and Carrie's other flat. So we had a little stroll down there and yeah, had a nice evening. And then yesterday was Saturday, it's currently Sunday, and me and Aiden went to his grandparents' house. We went there and they fed us lots of delicious food. They like hand make their own ravioli, which is just incredible. And it was so delicious. They filled our fridge pretty much, made us so much food and given us so many leftovers because they made so much for us yesterday. So we've got a lot of food, and we've got some fruit and veg that they gave us as well, and some like handy bits. They gave us some pots and pans, bless them. So yeah, yesterday was a really nice like family day. Aiden has gone out to get a haircut and we're going to go food shopping and do our first proper big food shop because our family has been like helping us out and got us a couple of bits to start us off. We haven't done like a proper big food shop, so we're gonna go do that. And then I think we might head to Oxford Circus and go and look around the homeware shops. I'll probably end up doing like a homeware and shopping haul when we get back, but that'll probably be in the next vlog because I feel like this vlog has gotten way too long. So thank you very much for watching. Hope you've been enjoying the new vlogs. This is the first week in the flat. I can't believe I've been here for a week already, but we're starting to settle in, bring my stuff over and make it more homely. The next big task is to get our sofa. So yeah, thanks for watching.
Make sure you hit the like button and subscribe if you're new to let me know that you're enjoying the videos. And I will see you very soon for another vlog. Love you all. Bye.